Scientists at CERN just announced a terrifying new discovery. The Higgs boson particle has been a mystery for quite a long time, ever since it was hypothesized, and that led to the creations of the Large Hadron Collider, an instrument that was significant to the study of the Higgs boson particle. Hello guys and welcome back to Salty Space. Join us today as we indulge into the many secrets of the Higgs boson particle. Did you guys know that the Higgs boson particle is known as a God particle? Well, yes, it is, and that's all thanks to many believing that it was the first particle that caused the Big Bang. So, in order to study this particle and learn more about it, the European organizations CERN built the Large Hadron Collider, which include a huge piece of machinery inside a tunnel. The machinery radiates beams of energy in a fast circle, and the collisions that take place in this tunnel have helped open up various secrets of the universe. In fact, the LHC has helped discover 59 new hadrons based on data collected from its first two operational runs. The Large Hadron Collider has been a project that many physicists have waited for ages, and after a long wait of many decades, it was ready in September 2008. But even after it was ready, it took CERN quite a while to work on some tweaks in the machinery to attain the best results. If you are wondering where the tunnel that houses this machinery is located, well, it's under the border of France and Switzerland, somewhere near Geneva, under the Jura Mountains. The reason why it was built here was that CERN did not want to spend a lot of money on land and also wanted to shield the project from the radiations produced by the Earth. As we mentioned earlier, there are quite a few collisions that take place in this tunnel that helps generate a database to contribute to the various particle theories. The first particle collisions that took place in 2010 was performed with an energy of 3.5 tera electron volts per beam, which is 4 times the previous world record. The energy level was later upgraded to 6.5 tera electron volts per beam, which showcased some magnificent collisions. The ensemble of the LHC comes with 4 crossing points where the accelerated particles collide. It also comes with a total of 7 detectors. Each detector is located around a crossing point and they help detect different phenomena. Another thing to note about the LHC is that it uses only heavy ions for the collisions, such as lead ions with lead ions or proton ions with proton ions. It ensured that this takes place for a month every year. The main purpose behind the creations of the LHC is to find out more about the Higgs boson particle, as well as to find out more about supersymmetric theories, and that is exactly what these particles help find out. But what exactly is a hadron? A hadron is a group of subatomic composite particles that were discovered in the late 1940s after a bunch of cosmic ray experiments were conducted. It is made of quarks that are held together by strong forces. Hadrons include baryons, protons, neutrons, and some mesons such as pions and kaons. The collider is what brings particles together and is a powerful research tool whose byproducts provide scientists with evidence to understand the structure of subatomic particles and the laws that govern them. The byproducts are produced by high-energy collisions only to decay after a short span of time. Between the year 2010 and 2013, 2 particles were made to collide, each of which was a proton of up to 4 electron volts. That's when the plutonium state of the particle was found out, and also the first creations to quark gluon plasma was discovered. Another important thing to note about the LHC is that it is regularly shut down to be upgraded. As of now, there have been 2 shutdowns so far, and the last point in time where it was turned back into operational mode was in April 2022. At this point in time, a maximum beam of 6.8 TeV was used, and this resulted in a crack in the Earth's magnetic field being observed. The crack was open for 14 hours and it raised quite a few questions. It further caused huge geomagnetic storms as well as beautiful aurora to be formed. The reason behind this was the co-rotating interactions region that was formed. The CIR is a bunch of large-scale plasma structures that are produced in regions of the heliosphere. It is located near the sun, and here slow-moving solar winds interact with each other, causing the CIR to be flung towards the Earth. It was on the 7th of July when a long G1-class geomagnetic storm was witnessed due to this phenomenon. These phenomena caused problems with satellites, radio communications, and power systems. But just 2 days prior to this, a new type of pentaquark was discovered. This pentaquark was made up of a charm quark and a charm antiquark, as well as an up, down, and strange quark. This was quite a discovery and opened up many doors to further research. Quite recently, the LHC was upgraded to a high luminosity LHC, where the luminosity level was improved. While the first operational run helped detect the Higgs boson, the second operational run helped detect major decay modes of the Higgs boson. Now the third and fourth runs are expected to use particles with higher amounts of energy as well as a more tremendous amount of collisions too. It is doubtful that the third run will help discover a new particle, but the fourth run has the potential to do so. CERN had plans of building a future circular collider that would make it the most powerful particle, but experts have been quite skeptical about whether it would be a worthy investment or not. That is all for today, and I'll see you in the next video.